Yeah, this is apparently the last level. So, you've made it. Just gotta finish the fight.
The funny thing is, it's not the entire theme song, because obviously you couldn't do that on the NES memory for music. So it's like the first, like, it's like the, it goes to like the Jane his wife part, and it just repeats.
Wow.
But I mean, that's better than some attempts I've seen where it's like, play the Yersia Yatsura game where the only song it has is like the first 5 seconds of the theme song, and it's
oh, God.
Fucking grating.
Yeah. I will say, as much as that show is fun, the theme song I thought was actually really bad. I didn't like it.
I'm fine with the theme song, but just hearing the first 5 seconds of it over and over again is very grating. Especially when represented pretty poorly on the NES.
Yeah. Yeah.
Granted, I also deem Yersia Yatsura NES is one of the worst NES games ever.
I've never played it, I couldn't say, but
there is a very old playthrough of it on my YouTube channel, where I did play through it. I don't know why I decided to do it, but I did it. It was pain.
Sounds like it.
Alright, let's see. Can we go up? Oh, it's gone! Well...
Oh, you're going to try to take the elevator?
Oh. Well, that was a waste.
Jump too high.
Oh, I wasn't expecting the ceiling to be quite that soon, for lack of better words.
I also don't think you were expecting it just to do this like rocket-like vertical jump with absolutely no forward momentum.
It doesn't help that there's no monsters here to, like, get me some coins, but I think that's the point.
Yeah, making things more difficult. You made it this far, not making it easy for you.
Oh no!
Did you take a tumble?
Sure did.
Dang it.
I look like I'm in the pistons of a fucking engine.
And this is the end of Fred Flintstone in the literal machine of progress.
I can't believe Fred Flintstone is dead.
Can't believe it. These are just really nasty jumps though. The sprites, though, when the pistons move up, they're just. If I hear sounds, I'm just going to assume something went horribly wrong.
It sure did.
Can
I just skip George? God damn it!
Nope, you gotta talk to Smiling George.
I almost want to like make a save state just so I don't have to keep talking to George Jetson. You're a douchebag, George.
Well, to be fair, his character sprite on the bottom is actually surprisingly good.
Yeah, that is actually really accurate looking. Hey, George, can we do a life swap?
Why does everyone keep saying that?
Wilma's being a bitch lately. Can I fuck your wife? Fred, she costs like... $1 million just to touch. Oh, well, fuck that shit. I'm poor enough as is. Jetson Meet the Flintstones has a scene where, like, Fred legitimately tries to kill Barney. He throws Barney out the window. And this is out the window of the Jetson house, I want to point out. So, if anybody has seen what is at the bottom of all those high-rise buildings, it's Barney.
It's Barney.
Which, because he's thrown down that, and everybody thinks he's, like, dead, and Fred's feeling remorse, and Barney just comes up on the elevator and is like, hey, guys. It's just, like, unharmed at all.
Well, you know, Barney is more resourceful than folks give him credit for, I feel.
That and probably real stronger than he looks because of all the times Fred's hit him in the head.
Another thing that I just think of, you remember that one when Cartoon Network used to do those music videos and did the one circles?
Yeah, where it's just Fred and Top Cat and everybody's just walking in circles.
Yeah, and the one part where Fred's like, I walk to the left, I walk to the right, then he finds Barney, and then he's so shocked, he just like grabs him, just like hits him in the head like three times. Oh, Bon, I'm so sorry. I'm just lost in this place. I don't know what's going on. I think I've passed that easy chair four times.
Oh gosh. Let's see here. That fucking fire again. You know what? Right. No, I'm not gonna waste my coins. I'll just keep walking through here because I get a heart. Anyways.
It's true.
At least they were nice enough to do that. They could have been total assholes and not.
Yeah.
Because I don't know how the hell I'm supposed to do that pixel-ass perfect jump.
I don't think you can even make it across this gap. This gap seems a little bit too big.
It's probably one of those things you have to get right on the edge or some shit.
Either that or I still think you're supposed to walk across the top, and then if you fall down, you land in the fire, and that's its only purpose. I don't know. I couldn't say. I don't understand how these things work. I've only to be able to think the way a Taito game designer from the early 90s works. You made the jump up there. That happened to grab the ledge. That's fancy. Curio, because every time he flaps, it uses 5 coins.
Yep.
So he has to ration them flaps.
Ration them flaps. That sounds.
That sounds incredibly inappropriate.
That sounds lewd. Gotta ration those faps. Oh wait, I mean flaps.
Well, you gotta do that too, otherwise you might go blind.
Or grow hair on your hands or whatever other.
Make sure. So basically, what you're saying is that Sasquatch is actually the end result of not rationing your faps.
Yeah, pretty much.
Oh dear.
You know what?
Chicken butt.
I'm safe stating. Because I don't really have to deal with George again.
that's understandable. George is... I don't think anyone wants to deal with him more than they have to.
I mean, his wife only deals with him so she can take his, like, wallet at the start of every episode.
Well, let's be honest, considering that it's one of those things, that's definitely one of those things that has dated the Jetsons, is the fact that you still have cash in wallets, because in the future, you know they're probably going to have to move entirely to just, like, digital payment.
Well, they're still using, like, what looks like CRT monitors, too, so...
Well, yeah, but I suppose it's also one of the, to be fair, one of those things where CRTs do have some benefits over LCD, just... I think it's going to be a few more years if people realize, oh wait, no, they are still good for a few things. At least I hope so, because it's getting increasingly hard to find good CRTs around here.
No, no!
That sounded like you fell.
This is evil.
The game said no. Wow, somebody, what is it, these platforms? Just in space, it's fine. Oh. Oh. Oh my god, that jump. That jump.
No. The worst part is you can see those platforms below you, and they're just spaced out enough to where you can't get to any of them.
Yep, that sounds about right.
So it just makes it more frustrating and irritating, because it makes it look like you can save yourself, but you can't.
It's like, here's some platforms that would be pretty great if they were closer to you. Too bad they're not. Sucker. Kyo is remarking that if you had you could actually use fly in the air, so you could actually save yourself if you wanted.
Oh, this is shit. So now I'm up here, I have to guess where the next platform is.
Well, no, you can use fly.
Well, yeah, but I mean, if I didn't have any coins.
True. But I think that might be why they had all those little dinky enemies that don't hurt that much up there, because you can just beat them up and get the,
Except they're kind of hard to hit with your club because they move so much. Oh shit, he's got a fucking bazooka!
What? I'm playing catch up here. What'd you just find? Oh god! It's a surprise. It's a surprise you got this gigantic gun.
I'm gonna have to take a vape real quick because I have to get over the fact that I'm playing a Flintstone game where some future guy has got a fucking bazooka to my face.
I still say this guy looks like future Hitler without the mustache.
I can see that. Oh god, Ted Turner's Hitler.
I don't know. I actually don't see the Ted Turner resemblance you're talking about.
I don't know. I think it's just a weird kind of, like, he's got a very pronounced chin like Turner does.
Oh no, he can't shoot you. You duck your head into the friggin' thingamabobber and...
The only problem with that is it means I can't, like, charge my club. Well, and to be honest, I probably wouldn't have ever thought of the Ted Turner thing if it wasn't for the fact that the instructions actually call him, you know, Dr. Turner. I glitched it! I fucking glitched it!
Drax, I don't think he looks like an elf, though.
His ears are kind of pointy. Aw, fucking piece of shit.
Oh, you had him in a bit of a stun lock, it looks like.
I am pissed.
But he's running away?
No, just wait.
Wait, what? Oh no, not the boxing glove robot.
It's one of those multi-tier fucking bosses.
Watch out, he's wiggling his dinger at you.
Why do they have to give me a multi-tier boss here? That was like the last thing I wanted, Taito. He's kind of hard to fight in the first place.
Well, the game really wants to give you a challenge, so you get your parents' money's worth.
I'm getting all that money I did not pay for this game worth. Though, to be honest, I probably will. I'm sure I will buy this game. I had a copy of it at one point. And when I had a really huge NES collection that I had to sell for monetary reasons, and I'll just leave it at that. Getting really tired of the Jetson theme.
It's like, wow, this is a great rendition of Jetson's theme. 5 hours later, I've had enough of this goddamn theme.
Or part of the theme.
Please, play a different part.
Oi. Okay. Oh shit. Nice. I'm surprised by my luck there. All right.
You know, sometimes you just get the luck, just take it. The game's not gonna give you that many bones, you just better just take it.
Oh, didn't let me stunlock him this time.
Wonder what?
Oh, I stunlocked him again. Or I did for a little bit. Oh! They do work!
They do?
Yeah, unfortunately it takes 10.
Well, I guess you know to save those for the jumping robot with the dinger.
Damn it.
What a weird boss fight this is.
It really is. Seemingly I can stun lock him sometimes. I don't know what's the determiner of whether or not it works.
I think just a really tight window, and if you're just a little bit too late, he comes out of it. Like a freaking 2-frame walks. Like, what's with bosses having the silliest looking walk cycles after Fred has such a good one?
That's where all the money went to. All the memory went to.
All the memory went to toward Fred having the perfect recreation of the Hanna-Barbera walk cycle.
Liking this boss because I can't jump high enough. One of the things I hate is I can't jump high enough to like jump over him.
Yeah, this seems like it seems pretty rough,
especially considering that he's gonna have another form.
Maybe you're literally just supposed to just. It's just a war of attrition sort of thing. Just basically beat him up before he beats you up.
Brute force it?
Yeah, maybe that's what you're intended to do.
Well, that's easier said than done.
Yeah, no kidding.
If I could just duck while I was charging...
No such luck.
I got an idea. Okay. He shoots two and then walks forward to me, so maybe if I, like, duck those two and then try for a charge shot. I think that worked. Mega Man called, they want their boss back.
Yeah, that went a lot better.
I hate this fucking... Oh, got him again! He's walking off on stilts now?!
He has a third phase?
Oh my god. What the fuck, Mega Man shit God, is this?
A cast in stilts. Cast in a... And, not stilts, Oh my God.
This is literally a Mega Man boss now.
Wily Capsule 0.5.
At least they let me, like, start back at this boss. That's...
Yeah. That'd be pretty mean if they didn't. God, this ring, though, it shoots at you.
I don't even know what hit me that time.
Is it only when it hits you? When you hit it? Yeah, it only shoots it when you hit it, when you hit him. Yeah, so it seems it only shoots the green ring when you hit him.
No, it'll shoot it whenever I haven't hit him. Or if I stay away from him enough, it won't shoot, though.
Okay. I was mistaken, then.
We're almost there, guys. I'm not sure what's hitting me at some point, so... Oh, okay, I guess if I hit the, track, just sometimes it'll, like... Okay. I think I might be able to do this.
Just give him that club. It's like, well, this is the most advanced future technology has to offer. Oh, yeah. Well, this is the biggest club I could bring with me.
Join the club!
It's in the manual.
Yes! Oh, now he's crawling off. Oh, please tell me there's not a fourth form. Please tell me there's not a fourth form. Oh, now a very miniaturized Dino and Hoppy is beating the shit out of him.
Oh my God, he's just crawling away and...
Dino, don't fuck Dr. Butler!
Oh my God, Dino looks so weird.
That is and the worst drawing just like of Pebbles and Bam Bam I've ever seen. I almost did. That sprite of Pebbles and Bam Bam in that scene was so bad that at first I actually almost said, "Who the hell are those kids?" and then realized. So we did it. We beat the Flintstones.
We did it.
I have to say, this was a pretty cool game. I'm actually really surprised with how good it is. Yes, there's some parts that made me want to punch a duck. But, I don't know why I picked that of all animals, but...
I don't know.
Made me want to punch, like, some things, but... I enjoyed this. It was really good. It's really well made. It's got some solid mechanics. I think it's a fun game. I wouldn't mind do a playthrough of the sequel at some point. What do you think, Crunchy?
Yeah, I'd be down for the sequel. I mean, like I said, it's a late NES game, so it definitely shows that they've gotten the hang of using the system. And the challenge, it's definitely short, but the challenge is high to offset it, and seems unfair in spots. But you know what? I think it's definitely one of those things where if you get good at it, you can plow through it real quick.
Right, and, well, yeah, there's some unfair scenes I've seen far worse in an NES game. And it's also kind of cool that they made it challenging when this is a game that was obviously aimed at kids in comparison to a lot of kids aimed games are really easy, or the more obviously, you know, the ones based on a kid license are usually pretty easy on the NES. And I'm glad we got through this with barely any reference of Granddad. Barely.
Dang it, you said it. It's too late. We almost made it out.
Granddad Flintstones.
Who made this game?
I did. Or one. I don't know. I like how Fred Flintstone's in the corner there going, yep, I'm in this.
I made this.
I'd say this is a solid game. I'll give it 4 out of 5 rocks.
I'll give it 3.5 out of 5 dum-dums.
Trax, I'm looking forward to seeing what Trax puts in for that.
Has he started actually adding visual things for those?
He'll do that sometimes in the he'll do those in the playthrough. Grant, I think sometimes he'll only do it when I say it and not the co-commentator, so I don't know.
Okay.
But yeah, I'd say that's a damn solid game. Good job, Taito.
Nicely done.
And with that, I'm going to end this stream. And if you guys are willing to wait for a little while, I will be doing art here shortly on Picardo. So. I got distracted looking at the chat, but there. So, yeah. See ya.
Laters.
Yabba dabba doo!
Yeah, okay.
Crunchy, my pebbles! And by that, I mean my child! Give her back!
Nope, 5-second rule, Fred. I have no idea.
Gee, we ought to do something, Fred.
Okay, how's about taking a nap?
Hey, I got a better idea. Let's take a Winston break.
That's it! Winston is the one.